Hello viewers and welcome to Atlantic TV. This is Atlantic News. My name is SL7 Adrian. For the headlines. News in full, we have Chairman and Chief Executive of Nigeria Drug Law Enforcement Agency, retired Brigadier General Muhammad Bubamuwa, has said drug users and addicts no longer have excuse not to seek treatment, with the commissioning of the modern 24/7 call center set up to attend to Nigerians from all parts of the country. Mawa spoke yesterday at the commissioning of the NDLEA call center with a toll-free helpline manned by professionals and experts in counseling, physiotherapy, psychology and psychiatry, among others, in Abuja. Amid growing concerns on people of the Niger Delta have released a 19-page demand, among which is immediate review of the Petroleum Industry Act, PRA 2021, by the National Assembly. The demand also came with an 8-point agenda conceived as a document eliciting personal commitment from citizens and accountability from policymakers and corporate operators. The Trade Union Congress TUC Oyo State Chapter yesterday vowed to mobilise for the presidential candidate of the Labour Party, PLP, Peter Obi, as directed by the National Body of the Labour Centre. The State Chairman of TUC, Emmanuel Ogundiran, while speaking in Ibadan, the Oyo State Capital, said the state councils will comply with the stance of the Labour Centres. Moving on to the business scene, we have the Nigerian Upstream Petroleum Regulatory Commission has expressed concerns about the country's production capacity, citing cases of deliberate short of oil wells and pipelines by operators who are trying to deal with theft. According to the NUPRC, the country's level of crude oil theft is estimated at a daily average of 108,000 barrels in 2022. And on the entertainment scene, we have Nigerian and businessman and politician Babatunde Olalere Badamosi, who is contesting for the Lagos State East Senatorial District, has mocked Nollywood actress Funke Akindele following her second marriage. Taking to his Instagram page, Babatunde, who has been in a long-term running feud with Funke Akindele, used her marital woes to berate her. He expressed his amusement at the breakfast that was served to her, but Badamosi revealed that more of it was coming for the actress. And that's how I wrap up the news right here on Atlantic TV. Do follow us on our social media platforms scrolling down your screen. Do have a lovely day ahead.